This video is regarding Burmeister's theory. Burmeister's approach to design the thickness of a flexible pavement or to design flexible pavements. This total theory is based on plate bearing tests. By conducting an extensive plate bearing test, there are different equations given by Burmeister's using which we can design the thickness of the flexible pavement. And there are some of the charts for deflection and stresses which we are going to use to design the pavements for the given stress value and for given deflection values. Now, before we start direct discussion on Burmeister's theory, just we will compare the Bostoner's theory and Burmeister's theory first. So if we check the Bostoner's theory, in that the layers, different layers of pavement are not considered. All the layers including subgrade is treated as a single layer with having same modulus of elasticity, and all the layers are treated as homogeneous and isotropic in nature. While Burmeister's layered system analysis states that the pavement and subgrade will never have the same modulus of elasticity, and pavement modulus of elasticity will be 100% greater than that of modulus of elasticity of subgrade. If we consider different layers in the same flexible pavement itself with different modulus of elasticity values, let us consider modulus of elasticity of subgrade is ES, modulus of elasticity of subbase is ESB, and modulus of elasticity of base is EB. Then as per Bostoner's theory, ES will be equals to ESB will be equals to EB. It means modulus of elasticity of subgrade, subbase and base are same. While if we considered a layered analysis and if we compare the modulus of elasticity values, then modulus of elasticity of base will be higher than subbase, and that in turn will be higher than subgrade. So this is the main reinforcing factor for the analysis of a layered system. Now there are some of the assumptions in Burmeister's approach. Just I will go through these assumptions. These are three assumptions of Burmeister's approach. The first one, the materials in the pavement layer are isotropic, homogeneous and elastic. The pavement forms a stiffer reinforcing layer having modulus of elasticity higher than that of underlying subgrade in two layer system. This Burmeister approach is two layer system, pavement and subgrade. In that, pavement is homogeneous, isotropic and elastic in nature, and this subgrade is also homogeneous, elastic and isotropic in nature, but there are two different layers with two different modulus of elasticity values. And the second assumption is the surface layer is infinite in horizontal direction and finite in vertical direction. The underlying layer in two layer system is considered infinite in both the directions. It means pavement top, pavement layer is infinite horizontally and finite vertically. Finite vertically means it is having some known thickness. And in the second line it states that the subgrade is infinite in both the directions, in horizontally and even vertically. It's fine. Then third assumption is the layers are in continuous contact. The top layer is free of shearing and normal stresses outside the loaded area. It means only the loaded area is treated as under stress. So these are some of the assumptions of Burmeister's approach. Here nomenclatures, ES is treated as a modulus of elasticity of subgrade, and EP is treated as modulus of elasticity of pavement. It is almost in a normal sense we can consider that pavement modulus of elasticity will be 10 times higher than that of subgrade. Now this is one of the diagrammatic differentiation between Bosonic theory and Burmeister's theory. The first half of the represents Bosonic theory, the other half represents Burmeister's theory. See here, there are no differentiation between the pavement and subgrade, and there are no thickness represented, and even the load distribution is uniform all over the pavement structure. While if the same pavement is divided and assigned with the two different models of elasticity values, then you can see the major difference. The 70% of stress is directly reduced to 30% on the top of subgrade. On the top of subgrade means maximum stresses are taken in pavement layer itself. Only small part of stresses will be distributed to the subgrade. This is the major difference that can be observed in layered analysis. If we come to the equations, these are two different equations. One is for flexible plate, other is for rigid plate. I think while working on plate bearing test and calculating the deflections, you might have used these equations. Here the delta represents the deflection. 1.5 is the constant for flexible plate. Here 1.18 is constant for rigid plate. P is pressure, A is radius of contact area, ES is as we already told you, it is modulus of velocity of subgrade. F2 is deflection factor, and here EP is modulus of velocity of pavement, and once again this is deflection factor F2. How we can resemble this or consider a Bosonic theory in Burmeister's approach? If we treat that pavement thickness is zero, then the whole layer will be a single layer, that is subgrade, and that is also obviously it will be having the single modulus of elasticity, and that represents the Bosonic approach. Here you see, if thickness of pavement is treated as zero, then both pavement and subgrade will be having same modulus, that both are subgrade itself. Then that ratio will be equals to 1, and then that deflection factor will also be 1. That you can refer in the upcoming charts that I will be discussing with you. So this that's why the here in the explanation they stated that this Bosonic theory, Bosonic analysis is a special case in Burmeister's approach. Burmeister's approach, it is a special case in Burmeister's approach. Okay, next before we start the discussion on problems, let us discuss about the different charts that we are going to use in Burmeister's theory. Okay. This is this deflection factor chart. This is deflection factor chart. The x-axis represents the z by a ratio, y-axis represents the deflection factor values, and these different curves represents even by E2 ratios. Here even is treated as the modulus of velocity of pavement, E2 is treated as modulus of velocity of subgrade. So even by E2 values, even by E2 ratios, these lines indicate. Depending on the ratio of modulus of velocity of pavement by modulus of velocity of subgrade, you can choose the different curves. Next chart is vertical stress chart. This is vertical stress distribution in two layer system for different values of E1 by E2. This is once again, these curves represent E1 by E2 values. This y axis represents z by a, and x axis represents sigma z by p, where p is the pressure. These depending on the required depending on the known E1 by E2 ratios, you can select the curve, and using z by a you can calculate stress, or by known stress you can design the thickness of the pavement. So these are two different charts that we are going to use in Burmeister's approach. Now let us go through different steps that need to be used in designing the